Hello everybody and welcome back. We are going to do a tutorial in... This thing shakes all the time. I need a new boom arm or some kind of mechanism that doesn't make this do this. Anyway, we're going to look at how to apply the gold foil effect from Heritage Type Co. This is one video in a series of videos I'm going to do in partnership with Heritage Type Co. The first one I did was on how to import vintage fonts from the vintage font bundle into Procreate. I'll link that right here somewhere for you to go check out if you're an avid Procreate user. We're going to apply this gold foil effect to a logo from Willow Run Boutique. We'll look at how to import that logo into the PSD, a couple different tricks on how to use it, and then how to export it with the texture that Heritage has given to you and without the texture. So let's go ahead and dive into Photoshop. I've opened up the file. This is her logo for Willow Run Boutique. I'm going to link her Instagram as well as the store down in the description for you to check out, but you can see it was delivered to me nicely packaged and bundled together, so we're not really editing different parts of the logo, but what we're going to do is drop it in Photoshop and make it something more like this with the gold foil effect. So I'm going to open this like we haven't done anything yet. So this is what it's going to give you, and you can see down here it says your design here, and then you have a toggle for the effect, a folder if you will, and the backgrounds and all that stuff. So what we're going to do is first we'll just double click into here and you'll see the little placeholder stuff going on. So what we'll do is we'll just go ahead and take that off, go back to Illustrator. So I would go ahead, I mean at this point this already assumes that you have a logo of some sort and you're just trying to apply the gold effect to it. Now if I go back to the final version of what she wanted, just notice that the turkey here is not gold. So, but I'm going to show you what happens if we just drop it in here is that everything's going to be gold. So I'll do this, copy, I'll go to PS, click paste. The menu is going to come up. You can play with how you want this. Once I know things are pretty much set from Illustrator, I just import it as a smart object. This is going to be a little big, but now it's completely resizable because it's going to be resizable regardless because it's Photoshop and Illustrator work together. But that's a little big, so I'm going to bring it down just a little bit. It's not going to be perfect. So now if I click OK and I'm good to go here, and you go back here, nothing's going to happen because you haven't actually saved this PSB file, right? Which is telling this file, hey, show this smart object, if you will. So what you have to do is you have to go up to File, and you have to go down to Save, which I know is a little bit cut off from the screen here. This monitor is huge. But now this has saved. Okay, you don't see any little asterisks up here on the top right. So if we go back to gold foil effect, here it is. Okay, and so this is like a little bit too blown out, right? The turkey is a little bit too blown out, so that's not really going to work. Now, the mountains, I think, work pretty well, and everything else, I think, works well, and it was up to par with what she wanted, except I knew that this was going to be an issue here. So if we go back to that original one over here, we can tell that the mountains are a little bit toned down, and then the turkey here is its own smart object. So let's just say that we go back to this initial file. Okay, so we go over here, we find that turkey, we just turn that turkey off. Okay, we grab the wrist of this right here, go back here. So Command C or copy or however you want to do it, go back to Photoshop. We'll just hide this, click into here, do a smart object again, that's fine. And then, so now we're turkeyless, okay, which is fine. So we'll go down like this, boom, go back to File, remember because we have to save that file, otherwise nothing's going to happen. We'll go back to gold foil effect, and now I think we're in a pretty good position here to drop that turkey in. We'll just copy that, so we've hidden everything else, selected it, copy, go back to Photoshop. You're already in here, you can select anywhere, it doesn't really matter. We're going to click Command V, and I do want this as a smart object because it's not like a, you know, it's not a drawing or anything like that. It's just an image. And so what we'll do is we'll place it in here similarly to how it was in the original. And you can either use, I mean, you can go back and forth between the Illustrator file. Let's turn that logo back on. And so you can see the tail is here, just like, you know, touching the R. I would say that a little bit more is kind of that aesthetic, like a little bit larger here. And so you can just play with that. And if I go back to the original one that was completed, I made the mountains like a little bit more. I actually added the mountains as its own object here. And I basically just dampened it. Now, this is fine. I think that they're a little bit dark. So what you would do is the same process. You would go back here. You would just find the mountains here in the back, right? Or whatever part of your logo. Let's just say, you could do every single piece of this differently if you wanted. So you could just go back to Photoshop, click into the your design here part, right? What's inside this place is, what's inside this PSB, this file that's telling the original file what to do, is going to show up gold, right? Which is all this, if we go into here and all this craziness that's going on, right? So you don't really want to go in there and mess with all that stuff. So you could piece, maybe you just wanted the frame to be gold and you just piece the logo in there. Well, you just pasted the frame in there as gold and then it just shows up gold and then everything else kind of retains this original, all these different colors. Now, I think it works like this, and I think that this is fine to have the mountains dark gold like that. But if you wanted a lighter version, you don't want it on black, you can go to the backgrounds and just select backgrounds and it'll be done. But if you notice, there's this crazy texture that's going on, so it's not actually white yet. It's okay, all you have to do is literally just click on it. But let's just say you want the pure, like, solid gold kind of runny effect here. And you wanted to export this as a transparent PNG, maybe for, I don't know, web design or whatever you needed. You can do that. So, right, so you've taken off the paper texture. Now you can see all these little checkers means that it's going to be exported as a transparent PNG. Or you can go in here, you can draw a box. And golly, that's super, super yellow. So let's just make that sucker white. And now, so clearly it's not going to be in the right place, but let's just go put it right here, okay? What we'll do is we'll take it all the way to the bottom. And so now we've got it on white, okay? So we've got this really nice gold effect on white. Turn that off, transparent. Go back to your texture layer, turn that on. Go back to backgrounds, turn that on. So you could go back in here too, and you could put this in here. And turn that on, and then boom, now it's white. And you know what I'm saying? So you play around with it. But the scariest part of this is not knowing how to apply the texture. And I think where the confusion is when you open this and drop your design in here, you think that it's going to work in here, but you actually have to save this file inside Illustrator. So file, save, or Command S, or whatever, and then it's going to poof, it's going to pop up here, and it's pretty magical. I made this a lot longer than it needed to be, clearly, but that's literally how you do it, and that's pretty much the end of it. So yeah, you can go export it as whatever files as you want, you can export it as a PNG, JPEG, whatever you want, but so you're going to have all the same qualities as any other file with the gold foil effect. Okay, so I hope that was helpful. Again, I probably made it that a lot longer than it needed to be, but a lot of times I think you can get frustrated because you have this really cool asset or file or whatever, and you can't get it work because of a, you know, simple just click in the wrong place, or you apply the effect but then you're like, oh, this one part doesn't look good with all yellow, all foil, all whatever. We could have got into how to change that gold to something else, which you could just kind of drop a picture in there and it already knows to apply it. Maybe we can do that another time, but just think about how you want your logo to appear. Do you want just the frame to be gold, you want the frame and the letters to be gold, just paste that part into the kind of smart object or smart file that says to the other Photoshop file, hey, do this. That's a really quick way to do it. You could design your whole logo in Photoshop. You could not. You could design it in Procreate and put it in there, whatever it is. You just got to double click on that your design here. They've already said pretty much what to do. Just save the file. Go to file, save. It's not going to freak out or start doing files on your laptop or whatever. Just play with it. If you have any other questions or concerns or issues, drop them in the comments. Find me on Instagram and we can go from there. Shout out to Willow Run again. Thanks for trusting me with your files and getting them back to you. Please go check out their store and their account. They're making amazing leather goods, and I think I have a journal in the works, and so I'm super excited about that. It would be amazing if you subscribe to the channel, like this video, share it with someone else that's really into getting into the heritage and the vintage style, because Heritage Type Co. has done all the work for you, okay? So they've done the research, they've done their homework, and they're pretty much killing the game. They've done it all for you. They're even labeling things as your design here. You just plug them in, and they're going to be amazing, okay? Thanks so much for watching this video. I hope this was helpful. Tag me on Instagram at SwagTalksDesign with your gold foil effect, and I'd love to see it, and I'll see you in the next video.